Operations. Online Trusted Store. Licensing with Entitlement ID. The prerequisites for any online activation on Trusted Store are: the LMU is installed in a trusted environment. An internet connection is required and the connectivity to the back office license server is tested. An email of the license ordering is present at the customer site, or for Siemens employees the information is also available via LMS cockpit. Some products, like Dizigo CC or Cerberus DMS, do support the activation of licenses on Trusted Store, which means that the license is bound to hardware components of the machine in the trusted environment. The workflow with Entitlement ID offers the advantage that only one ID needs to be copied from the license email and pasted into the tool, and that by subsequently retrieving the licenses from the back office server, only the activation IDs, still available, are displayed in the tool. We are now performing the activation with the Entitlement ID. In the tool, the page Activatable Items and the node Entitlement ID in Trusted Store are selected. Now we need the email of the license ordering. Each license email contains one Entitlement ID and represents the license model and the product that a customer has bought with quantity. Each entitlement can contain one or more products. In our example, the entitlement contains 6 products articles. Each article has an own activation ID. Select the entitlement ID and copy it. Paste the ID in the field Entitlement ID and click on the button Retrieve Entitlement. The status bar shows the process flow. The information in the operation pane changes and the radio button for online activation is selected automatically. In the view pane, all products of this entitlement are listed in the activate line items in detail, including activation IDs, version, expiration, the number of purchased, remaining and installed quantity. And at the end, the part numbers. The tool offers the possibility to activate the different elements individually, in groups or all together. As soon one of the products is selected, the Activate License button is enabled to perform the activation process. By selecting this checkbox, all products will be selected at once, or reverse deselected at once. When a product was purchased in a quantity higher than one, in our example 3 clients were purchased, it is possible to activate a subset of it by changing the number of install count in case not all counts are to be activated. Another use case could be not selecting the start feature set product, because it is not activated until shortly before project delivery. In the operation pane, there is the possibility to select a specific start date. If the start date is not given, it immediately activates the license. In our case, we select all elements. The install count for the client is 1. We keep the actual date as start date for all elements and perform the activation by clicking on the button Activate License. The status bar shows the online activation performance. Finally, a window pops up confirming the successful operation. In the view pane, one product is left because in this product the license of 2 remaining clients have not been activated yet. In the title bar we can see 2 changes, the customer site ID and the subscription expiration date is now displayed. After activation, we find the licenses on the page Licensed Products pane. By opening the tree in the navigation pane, all installed products are visible. We do the same in the view pane, in the Licensed Products page. The single products are indicated with the T symbol, which means that this is a Trusted Store license, and the trust flag has the status fully trusted. Further, we have the following information: activation IDs, issued date, what date the license is started on, the expiration, the CSID number, and that the CSID is enforced. This is the reason why the CSID is displayed in the title pane. By clicking on the small arrow, even more information of the product in question will appear. In the Licensed Products page, there are also the buttons Expand, Collapse, Create License Report, Does Create a Report in TXT format, and the Refresh button helps to retrieve the newest update from the back office server. In case of failures or red market fields, the consistency check can be used to deliver structured and formatted error messages for each feature. The message contains feature name, version, and rule which has caused the failure, including all dependent features. More information is available in the help document. Licensing with Activation ID. The prerequisites for any online activation on Trusted Store are: the LMU is installed in a trusted environment. An internet connection is required and the connectivity to the back office license server is tested. An email of the license ordering is present at the customer site, or for Siemens employees the information is also available via LMS cockpit. We are now performing the other operation supported by this tool, the activation with the activation ID. For the online activation of licenses on Trusted Store, the workflow with the use of the entitlement ID showed just before is the recommended and more convenient workflow. Let's assume that for a project the customer has a larger group of employees who will work with the product and needs multiple licenses. A large purchase order has been made, which contains all the elements with quantities. Also, in this case the email of the license ordering contains one entitlement ID with a larger list of products and activation IDs. The person responsible for the distribution of licenses to the customer employees can now deliver to each employee the elements necessary for his purposes with the activation IDs. In the tool, the page Activatable Items and the node Activation ID in Trusted Store are selected. The operation pane is different to what we have seen with the Entitlement ID, and shows now an Activation ID field and an additional field called Install Count. This field Installed Count can be used if not all counts are to be activated. And the radio button is set as online. Now we need the email of the license ordering. Each license email contains one entitlement ID and represents the license model in the product that a customer has bought with quantity. Each entitlement can contain one or more products. For our purpose, we use three products: the standard feature set, the client, and the electrical data points. Each activation ID for each product must be copied individually and entered in LMU individually before the whole list can be activated. Paste the copied activation ID of the first product in the field Activation ID. Also here, it is possible to select a specific start date, but we use the current date again. By clicking the button Add Activation ID, the product appears in the Activate Line Items page. We repeat this workflow also with the two remaining products. The client product was ordered in a quantity of 3. In the actual case, we need only one to be activated. After pasting the activation ID, in the install count field, we just change the default setting from all to 1, in this case. In the view pane, 3 products with activation ID are visible and the activation license button is enabled to execute the activation. We click the button and perform the activation. Also in this case, a window pops up confirming the successful operation. The CSID is showing the customer site ID and the subscription expiration date is displayed. Let's change to licensed products, where the 3 licensed products are visible. The license for client was activated in the quantity of 1, as desired. The tool behaves now the same as when licensing by entitlement ID, and offers the same features we have already learned. Online return of licenses. After activating licenses, the tool in the operation pane allows to return the license online. This function transfers the license rights back from trusted storage to the back office server. This feature is effective only for the online Trusted Store operation mode. License activation on Trusted Store means that the license is bound to hardware components of the machine in the trusted environment. Therefore, Trusted Store licenses must be returned online for the following reasons. If it is foreseen that a physical machine will be replaced. If it is envisaged that replacement of hardware components will take place on a computer. If it is foreseen that a virtual machine in a trusted virtual environment will also be replaced or copied. If major Windows updates are planned or a major Windows version upgrade is imminent. In cases of hardware components change, consequently the trust flag loses the fully trusted status and thus the license becomes invalid. The workflow is as follows. In the licensed products page, expand the license or licenses. It is possible to return all or single elements. Select in the tab Return. Remove of the operation pane. Select the online return radio button. In our case, we check all elements and return them to the license server by pushing the button Execute. With the acknowledgement of the window pop-up, starts the process. The status bar shows the performance status. Finally, a window pops up confirming the successful operation. The license is now deactivated on this computer and it's available for reactivation on another machine, or on the repaired machine with new hardware components, or on the same machine with updated or upgraded operating system. Repair of online trusted stored licenses. The online trusted store operation mode supports another feature that is only valid for licenses on trusted store. The repair feature. Licenses in the trusted store may get damaged in case of hardware changes or when the system time changes more than 24 hours. This example shows the trust flag status on host time. This is when the system time has changed more than 24 hours. With this, the repair button enables and allows to perform the repair function. In the previous topic, we pointed out the situations in which the licenses must be returned and then reactivated without losing validity. However, in certain cases the license can be repaired. To understand the topic better, we use a document from the GMS family, or in other words the DeZego CC product series, the document license validity in DeZego CC. Other products also using the method of trusted store licensing might provide similar information. This document lists the cases in detail where licenses in DeZego CC can be repaired or not. The first table in this document refers to the case where the product runs on a physical machine. In three cases, the license can be repaired. And the second table refers to cases where the product runs on a virtual PC and which of these cases can lead to a license that cannot be repaired. This information shows how important it is to return the license before performing such actions. Follow these steps to repair licenses. First, select the licensed products view. Click on the tab Repair in the operation view. Make sure the online radio button is selected. Select the trusted store license you want to repair. Click on the repair button to execute the task. If the operation is successful, the system will display the operation completed successfully message and features can be checked out successfully. In cases where this function cannot repair the license, please contact customer support.